Hi everyone, this is Richard with Richard K Photography. Today I'm in studio and I wanted to talk to you about a video slider, DSL slider that I just made. I've been trying to get into video a little bit more, so I've been watching some YouTube tutorials on some DIY sliders. I can't remember exactly who I found this one from, but basically, it's the use of skateboard wheel bearings cut on a piece of wood, which I plan to change, probably do metal or some type of different material just for durability. But it is a cheaper way. This has 8 wheel bearings on a 90 degree plate here. I don't know if you can see all that. And that just rolls on a track. Now, with this setup, you can run it on any, pretty much any round tubing, PVC pipe, metal pipe, pretty much anything. I've seen people where they've actually taken PVC pipe and heated it up a little bit and actually bent it to make kind of an arc. And this flows on an arc surface as well. So from there, what I wanted to do was make my actual slider, my slider rail. And again, I've seen a couple DIY videos about using PVC, and I thought that was great, but I wanted more of the professional look. I didn't want to show up to a shoot or to an event with, you know, a piece of wood with PVC pipe mounted to it. Whether you spray paint it or not, you can still kind of tell what it is. So what I did was I grabbed some metal rods, some round tubing. This was 3 feet, 2-3 feet round metal tubing, along with a couple square tubings. These were cut, I think, at like 18 inches a piece on the back end, with some supports, and then a metal plate, which I welded on a nut that would mount onto my tripod. And I just found that it's a little bit heavier, but it actually, it's amazing, it's stable. Now this does require welding. A lot of the DIYs using PVC piping and stuff, you know, it was basically screwing down the PVC pipe and calling it a day. Which is nice, it's a little cheaper. This here was probably, I would say about $20 to $25 to make. Obviously the welding you would have to do. Now if you don't have a welder, or not sure how to weld, you know, check your local community colleges that offer welding shops and just kind of pop in and go in there and tell them what you need done. And I'm sure you can get one of those guys to get it done for you for, you know, a reasonable price. and like I said, the reason I went this way was because of the durability, the fact that I can throw this in the back of my truck and make it, you know, easy to transport and durable. Again, your camera sits on top of your base and it's, you know, it's great. It runs smooth, a nice smooth surface. Excellent for traveling, a traveling slider. If you need to, you know, come in this way and do like a front slider, it's excellent. If you are going to try and weld this on your own, I do recommend you keep it clamped to the table, because as it heats up, the metal does tend to bend. So you know, you want a nice even level surface so that when you're doing your pan outs, everything's nice and smooth. So again, this is my DSL slider, and I'll just show you really quick. This is my tripod that I use, and just take your head unit off. The nice part about my tripod is that it does fold all the way down, so it can get pretty close to the ground, so you can get those low line shots. And then too, you can just place this on the ground if you wanted to. So again, with the screw, you're just gonna mount tucks in nice. And there you go. You know, you can put a level ball inside if you want to check your levels. And again, your camera would sit here on the track. And you're just going to smooth pan out. Of course, I would have my tripod head on there, you know, my camera on top of that. And then I've seen people add an extension, so if you want to higher, raise your camera a little higher so that when you're actually doing shots this way, you're not picking up the track. So there's a lot of options this way. Again, this is really durable. This is about 3 feet. I am going to make a larger one that stretches out. So that's going to be nice. And again, I'm probably going to change this platform to probably a metal of some sort or something a little bit more durable, something that looks a little cleaner. So, but other than that, you know, when you're done and you're on location, you just twist this off and, you know, you're pretty much good to go. You know, fold your tripod up. And these bars are just your track stoppers, but it also doubles up as a nice holder. So hope that helps. Hope someone benefits from this. And again, I'll show some clips of me actually using this. And I'll post that at the end of the video. Make sure you subscribe. Check me out on Facebook at Richard K Photography. Follow me on Instagram at Richard K Photo. And if you have any questions, feel free to email me. All right, thanks a lot, guys.